Hope for those with a debilitating genetic disease.
And medical reporter Dina Baer has more on a potential treatment that may help patients with muscular dystrophy.
There are more than 50 forms, but not one cure-all treatment for the disease that causes progressive muscle weakness. Patients lose strength in their limbs, core, even their heart and breathing function suffers. For decades, doctors have been searching for a way to stop the damage. Now, local researchers hope a lucky discovery in the lab will lead to better function for patients.
It's a process Dr. Elizabeth McNally and her research collaborators have been trying to stop for 20 years. You can see the damage here. The blue represents scar tissue in a muscle sample taken from a mouse with muscular dystrophy.
So instead of having a muscle full of muscle cells, it's now full of scar cells. And a lot of that scarring process is driven by this TGF-beta molecule.
Scientists made the discovery early on. A potential target called TGF-beta.
It was one of those long shot things where you say, well, let's try this and let's see what the genome teaches us. Can it show us a pathway that makes this work? And so when we got this first hit, it was really one of those like, wow, that was kind of lucky.
As luck would have it, TGF-beta plays a critical role. Too much of it causes scar tissue to form. From there, the researchers went to work on an antibody, a drug designed to lessen the amount of TGF-beta in the muscles, thus reducing the amount of damage and weakness.
Not to make so much scar, and the interesting part is we also found it stabilizes the muscles, makes them less vulnerable to injury, and it also helps the muscles grow bigger.
They tested the treatment in mice with the disease. This is tissue taken from the diaphragm, or breathing muscle.
So in these mice, they were treated early on in the disease, and then they were treated for 6 months. So we actually are slowing the progression of the disease. And so now we're currently looking to see if we can actually reverse the scarring.
The team is optimistic their antibody will work in human patients, even those with the most severe form known as Duchenne muscular dystrophy. Still, there are limitations when it comes to applying a treatment that works in mice to human medicine.
That's true, and we know that. But why we have some faith in, for example, this pathway that we're modifying, we actually think this therapy will be useful for many different forms of muscular dystrophy.
Dr. McNally hopes to produce more of the antibody and test it for safety before taking it to human patients. She's hopeful the next steps will move quickly, much like the process to produce COVID-19 antibodies. Back to you.